How's it going, everybody? So in this video, I'm going to be sharing how I choose the perfect family car. So before I got married, me and my wife, we both have our individual cars. But after we got married, plus I work from home, we decided that there's no point to have two cars. So what we end up doing is selling my wife's car on Carsem, and I'm going to leave the link in the description somewhere here of our experience. And we only want to maintain one car for our entire family. So that one family car must fit a few criteria that we think is important for our lifestyle and possibly expanding family in the future. I've narrowed down a bunch of car models that I think make a good family car in Malaysia. So number one is the Proton X70. The second one is the Mazda CX-5. And then the third option is this one, the turbocharged Honda Civic. So we're gonna share why we think it's the best family car for us. The number one reason why we chose the Honda is that it's a very established brand here in Malaysia, and it has a pretty good track record when it comes to reliability. Don't rely on car forums, because people can chit-chat about anything in there. So how I would make an educated guess is to go on the used car dealer website and check the secondhand value of this car. So this car costs 125,000 ringgit brand new when we got it, and even after 5 years and you look at the price for these cars, it's still being sold around 90,000 ringgit, which is ridiculously high. A high used car value means that a lot of people want this particular model. And why would a lot of people want this particular model in the used car market? It's because it's reliable. Because if it's not reliable, I think the secondhand value will drop significantly, like Continental cars. So after a certain year, there's a lot of things that goes wrong with it. The value plummet, but not a Honda. So to me, that shows that this car is a good, reliable car, which is what you want in a family car. All right, one of the main features that I look for in a family car is the safety feature. Because if you think about it, you're going to be carrying your family, your wife, your partner, your husband, and also possibly your kids in this car. So in my opinion, I want this car to be as safe as humanly possible. All right, let's take a look at why I think the Honda Civic is pretty good in this section. All right, so the first thing that you're going to notice about this car is just how low to the ground it is. So if I stand right next to it, you can see that it's barely taller than my chest area here. So the low height, and also if you notice that the distance between these wheels, the front wheels and the back wheels, quite long, low height, and you get kind of a sporty tire over here. All of these recipes combined together makes the car handle quite well at high speed. So when you're driving along the highway, you feel that it's very stable. So a stable car would translate to you as a driver that it feels more confident. But if you get an SUV, the SUV tends to be quite tall, so the center of gravity is quite high. So you can feel that a tall SUV is kind of wobbly at high speeds, and it's a little less confident inspiring compared to a vehicle like this, which is a lot lower to the ground, which is actually a lot safer, in my opinion. The other thing I like about these Honda Civic turbocharged models is that it comes standard with 17-inch, somewhat sporty wheels and tires. So these sporty tires give me confidence as a driver, even in wet conditions. So I'm pretty happy with these tires that come stock standard from the factory, but they're a little pricey. So they're gonna cost you around 400 ringgit to replace per donut. The other good thing is that the Honda Civic comes with a 6 airbag as standard, regardless of the model that you choose. So for the Honda, you got 2 in front, 1 for the driver, the other one is for the passenger over there. It says so, airbag. And we also have side curtain airbags. See there, side curtain airbags. And then it says the same thing at the back, somewhere there. So the other cool thing about the Honda Civic is that it comes standard with the reverse camera. So put this in reverse, and you have the reverse camera right there. You can see that there's a pillar at my blind spot. So assuming that you parked at a really busy mall and you're trying to go out, you can slowly ease out and you can sort of see on your left and right, much better than if you were to just poke out your head left or right from here. There's a big blind spot that you can't see, but with the reverse camera, you can sort of see who's coming from your left or right. Really cool. Alright, so down here we have another safety feature called the Hill Start Assist. So basically what the Hill Start Assist does is, let's say you're crawling in a traffic jam when you're going uphill. So the moment you let go of your brake, your car kind of slides back a little bit. Yeah, so the Hill Start Assist, if that is on, which it is on by default, it will know that if the car has a potential to slide back, and it will automatically hold the brakes for you until you hit the gas pedal to move forward. So it prevents your car from rolling back when you're at a uphill slope. Pretty smart. This particular Honda Civic is the middle spec turbocharged. There's another one which is the high spec. I'm not sure what it's called, but the top spec one has all the bells and whistles. So the top spec has Honda sensing. So it has a camera up here with some AI technology. So it scans in front. And if you happen to be in an emergency, it can sort of emergency brake for you if you didn't do it yourself as a driver. That's quite handy in the city. Maybe you're distracted, you're looking left and right, and then there's a car that was stopping right in front of you, and that will cause some low speed collision. So with that system, it can help to prevent that sort of thing from happening, which is a really nice touch. So the other cool safety feature is Honda Lane Watch, which this particular spec does not have. So what that is it will have a camera at the side mirror there pointing towards the blind spot of this car on the left. So every time when you turn the left signal on, it will turn on that camera and it will show here what's in your blind spot, which I think is a really, really nice touch. So if you can afford it, definitely get it. So the other reason why I feel like the Honda Civic Turbo is a really great car is that it has power, but it's also fuel efficient. So the way that Honda achieves this is by using a smaller capacity engine. This is only 1.5 liter. It's a really small engine, but it's turbocharged. To give you an understanding of what a turbo is, let's first explain how a regular engine works. So inside most engine, there's gonna be a bunch of cylinders going up and down. So above that cylinder is gonna be a combustion area. So that combustion area is where they squirt fuel, they spark it to ignite the fuel, where they will have combustion. Explosion that happens inside that chamber will push that cylinder down, and that up and down motion will go into the gearbox, to the wheels, and eventually to the road. And that's how a normal engine works. Now, how big is the combustion chamber will dictate how much power does the engine make. If it has a small chamber, then they can only squirt so much petrol and squeeze so much air inside that chamber for it to combust properly. A bigger engine, the combustion chambers are bigger. They're able to squirt more petrol in and squeeze more air in to combust, therefore having a bigger explosion and pushing the cylinder down even stronger. As a driver, you feel like the car is more powerful. But because of the engine is big, it burns more fuel and therefore would cost you more money to run. But if you think about it, do you really need all that power all the time? Most of the time, you're cruising on the highway, stuck in traffic jam, you don't need all that power. So it's just running on the 1.5 liter engine, which is a really small engine. But the moment you step on the gas, you want power, you want to overtake. That's when the turbo kicks in, and a turbo is basically a fan. It pumps more air into the same amount of area, and when there's more air, you can squirt more petrol in. So for that short period of time, you get extra boost in power, but it's only when you really step on the gas. So practically, the concept makes a lot of sense. So the salesperson said, for a 1.5 liter engine, when the turbo kicks in full whack, it produces power almost like a 2.4 liter normal engine. So that's really cool. So I think the smaller capacity engine, but turbocharged, will be the way of the future. A lot of cars will be doing this. All right, so the next thing I'm gonna be talking about is family-friendly features. Now there's one feature that I think is severely underrated, and it's called remote start stop. So I'm gonna paint you a scenario. You bring your family to a restaurant somewhere and you parked under the scorching sun. So after you're done eating, you wanna return to your car, but you know it's gonna be really hot to get into that car. So what do? You press this button to remote start your car and the AC will be on full whack. So by the time you're done paying, your family walks back to the car, the cabin's all nice and cool and comfortable for everybody. Now that is an underrated feature. All right, let me show you. So here's the remote. You gotta press the lock key once, and then you gotta hold down this button for 6 seconds. So another feature really nice to have is the brake hold button. If you're crawling in traffic, when the car is brought to a complete stop, it will hold on the brakes for you. So you don't have to keep your legs jammed onto the brake like what it is right now. So let me show you how that works. So you press this button. So right now the system is activated and it's currently holding onto the brake. So if I let go of my pedal, the car would remain at a standstill. See, we're not moving. It's in D. The brake hold is on, it's holding onto the brake. So if you want to move, you press on the gas a little bit and the car starts to move. At the moment you come to a complete stop, it will hold on to the brake again until you hit the gas pedal again. Now, I think this is not only a cool feature, it's beyond cool. I think all cars in Malaysia need to have this brake hold feature. I'm not even going to consider a car that doesn't have the brake hold feature. Matter of fact, I was actually considering also the Subaru XV, but the Subaru doesn't have the brake hold feature, and just because of that, that's one of the main reasons I don't consider the Subaru at all. You need this, especially in Malaysian traffic. And the other thing is, just look at the amount of legroom that I have back here. This is crazy. A Honda Civic is not a luxury car, but look at the space. This is luxury to me. I got a lot of headroom as well. If you're living in Malaysia, you have a family, you probably have kids back here, you probably have to drive your parents around or in-laws around. I'm not even going to consider a car that doesn't have rear aircon vents. That's ridiculous in Malaysian weather. But for the Honda Civic, it comes standard regardless of what spec you have, even the lowest spec. Nice. So the other creature comfort is the USB ports. So you got two here at the front, so at least the driver and the front passengers doesn't have to fight for the USB port. So for the rear passengers, we have one USB charger here that they need to share for the people back there. So this is actually not that good. It's only 1 amp. It is going to charge your phone, but it's going to charge your phone really slow. But at least it's better than nothing. The other really cool feature that I think is underrated is the walk away auto lock feature. Turn off the engine and you walk away, and when you reach a certain distance away from the car, it will lock itself. Now you'll be like, hey, what's the big deal? A lot of cars have this, but not all cars have it. And I think if you want a convenient family car, you need to find a car that does have it. Allow me to demonstrate. So let's say right now, I drove back, I'm at home right now, I'm gonna turn off the car and I'm gonna go grab my stuff and walk out. The car will lock itself. I got a lot of stuff here. I got a lot of stuff. So I can't lock it myself. Look, as I walk away, the car just locked itself. How cool is that? All right, there you go. That's my little review of the Honda Civic after been driving it for a couple of years. So I hope this video has been helpful for you to figure out what to look out for in a good family car. All right, so that's it for this video. I'll see you in the next round. Bye.